Hi, my name is Yashasvi Khanmangare.
I'm Rasika Bandarnaike.
You know how passionate I am about sharing food with my friends and loved ones.
Practically, I'm a foodie. I love eating food and I love cooking food.
There are lots of ways to make quick dinners, to make quick lunches that are healthy.
Every family have their own flavor.
It's time that we re-embraced our food culture.
The most important ingredient in whatever you make is love.
So it's a really simple recipe to make.
And this is my homemade. I'm Rasika Bandarnaike, a banker by profession who loves food and who craves to cook good food to your loved ones. Today we are going to make a chicken dish which is infused with mango chutney. This is actually a family favorite of mine. And normally we actually make it with pork, but today for y'all I'm making it with chicken because that is more practical. So let's start. So here I have 6 chicken thighs, mango chutney to your taste, ginger, garlic, soya sauce, tomato sauce and onions. Apart from that, you could add chili, salt to your taste and pepper to your taste. So first we need to make the sauce for this. First of all, let's cut some onions. This is only for the temper of the sauce. It doesn't have to be all neat because this is going to end up in the sauce and people will not actually notice how good you have cut the onions or the garlic. I normally put a lot of ginger in my food, ginger and garlic. So this depends on your taste bud. If you want, you could add ginger. If not, you could actually make it without it. So this would do for the temper of the sauce. So start off the sauce. I'm going to add some oil. Let the oil heat well. So now the oil is heating. So I'm going to put all the onions, garlic and ginger to it. You could actually temper it in medium heat. It has to caramelize well. Always have all the onions, garlic and ginger evenly spread in the pan. So now I can get a nice smell from the garlic. So when you get that smell and when you see that the onions are transparent, you could add a bit of chili powder because my family likes this dish a bit spicy and hot. But make sure that the chili will not be burned before you add the rest of the ingredients. Now I'm going to add the chutney. The aroma which you get out of this sauce actually wakes all my neighbors up and even my husband. Now you could add the tomato sauce. Like I said, this is a very easy dish because the sauce does not even take 10 minutes of your time to make. Let it simmer a bit like this. Now you could add pepper to your taste. Don't worry about this dish being hot because anyway, in the end, the dish will be baked. The chicken dish will be baked. So make it a bit spicy, don't be afraid. And at the end, you could add some salt. But be careful when you add salt because the chutney and the sauce anyway has The tomato sauce anyway has salt. So now this is ready. We could let it cool while we now boil the chicken or any meat item which you will make this with. First, I'm going to just lay the chicken like this evenly across the pan. It should not curl up. So I'm going to add some water. You don't have to go overboard with water for chicken because chicken anyway has water. And now you could add cloves to your taste, cinnamon to your taste, then cardamoms, pepper, and salt. The most basic ingredients are used for this dish, but at the end, this can even sometimes beat some of the five-star cuisines. That's as per my family. So as you see, I have actually used skinned thighs because it's important that we actually leave the skin on for these chicken pieces for the flavor to absorb. If not, the chicken will be very dry. And the cardamoms, the cloves and the cinnamon can be added to your desire. Also, the chicken need not be fully boiled because we will be anyway baking this with this beautiful sauce for around another 10 minutes time. So the chicken need not be fully boiled. So now our chicken dish is done. Take it off the stove and arrange it. Spread it equally so that the delicious sauce which we made will also be spread evenly. You could also add whatever which is remaining in the pan because those are the good stuff. And now for this glorious sauce needs to be added on top of each piece of chicken. There are days where I add a bit more of chutney, so it all depends on my mood. Today I'm in a mood where I don't need my food to be that sweet. So before you bake, you could also add some soya sauce, as that gives a nice color to your chicken. And people will wonder how you actually ended up with this color on your chicken. So this could take around 20 minutes of time in the oven. You could actually put it under 250 Celsius, but again, you could actually do as you wish according to your mood. You could actually, when you see that the sauce has absorbed the meat, you could actually take it out. So there is no hard and fast rule that you have to stick to 20 minutes. So now we have the dish which we've just got out of the oven and it looks awesome. So today I actually kept it for 15 minutes because it looked done and it looked good. So likewise, you could also just do it based on your liking. And now I'll just show you how I'm going to garnish it today. You could also just serve it the way it is with the tray itself, so that anyone who wish to eat the gravy as it is could do. If not, you could just drain it and get only the mango pieces, which I'm going to do now. So you could eat this with a macaroni dish, garlic bread preferably, or any kind of bread. It goes with any bread or bun. To add a bit of color, I'm going to get some parsley and chop it finely and just sprinkle. So this is done only for y'all, because at home we don't have the patience to just garnish it. We just have it out of the tray. So this is the end product of the mango infused chicken. And I'll say how it is. So look how it's done. So this is how it should be. And it's not dry. It's not dry at all. When I cut into it, I can actually feel how good it can taste. It tastes horrible. No, I'm just kidding. It's so good that I can just eat all of this. So let us know how it came out when you tried this at home. Like I enjoyed the time making this dish, I hope that you will also make this to your family members and make this dish a family favorite of yours. So this is my homemade, and please join us in our next episode, Homemade.
I think that food and food culture is an integral part of our families and our lives. I think cooking at home is something that must be revived. It's something that doesn't take a lot of time. Let's not forget that our love for food and our love for home-cooked food, and it's time for a revival. Hello, my name is Yashasvi Khandankara, and I'm joining you today with Homemade to share my passion for food with you. If you have been following my blog on Instagram, Cook, Eat, Review, Repeat, you'd know how passionate I am about sharing food with my friends and loved ones. Today, we're introducing chicken dumplings with a ground green chili, kithu treacle, and soy dip. Dumplings we're making today are the traditional Chinese dumplings. They've become quite popular in Colombo of late, and you can find over 10 dumpling places in the city. So this is a very easy variation of it. Because of the ingredients that I'm using, it's also more simple in terms of preparation and purchase of ingredients. So while we're stepping away from an authentic Chinese recipe, it'll also make it easier and simpler to prepare at home. So let's start. The ingredients we're using today is chicken meatballs and some seasoning that comprises chili flakes and salt. For the dipping sauce, we're using green chili, shallots, kithu treacle, soy, and sesame. To start the dish, keep a pan on low heat and add an oil to it that doesn't impart a lot of flavor, like sunflower seed oil or virgin coconut oil, or an oil that isn't very overpowering. We add the chicken meatballs. You can use a small pack for about 20 or so dumplings, and you just have to brown them so they kind of seal and have like some caramelization on it, because it helps if the meatball gets sticky inside the dumpling. It will take roughly about 5 minutes or so on the stove. For the dipping sauce, you need ground green chili, shallots, soy, treacle, and sesame seeds. We're doing an east-west sort of combo where you use traditional Chinese dumpling dipping sauce recipes with a Sri Lankan twist to it. In terms of fresh ingredients, you will need shallots, about a half a cup of shallots with the same amount of soy. I'm using roughly about half a cup of chopped shallots. Meanwhile, when the meatball is cooking, just turn it around so you get that sort of browning on all sides of it. You can use shrimp, you can use calamari, you can really experiment with what kind of meat you want, even beef, pork, chicken, any sort of minced meat would work. So it should be okay now. If you can see, it is sort of caramelized all over. So to start making the dipping sauce, you first need 3 large green chilies. Just chop it up roughly because we are going to grind it to not a paste but almost bruise it so that the kind of sweet chili flavor comes out. So if you have a small mortar pestle, it'll help rather than something large. Add the green chilies in first. So I'm going to use the treacle because it'll help it sort of not splash on me. So keep mashing it while adding the sweetness. So if you can see, it's just bruised. It's not like I've made a paste of it. So that because I don't want it to be very sort of spicy, so it's just bruised to impart enough spice to it. So to this, you can in any order that you like, add the soy, add the remainder of the treacle. Then I have toasted some sesame seeds. What you can do is like take a dry pan, no oil or anything, and toast it so it has some sort of crunch and brownness to it. It has a nutty flavor that adds to the sauce. And sesame is quite popular in Chinese cooking, so it adds authenticity. And these are the shallots. I think you call them green onion or spring onion here. And just sort of it in roughly. Just apply some pressure so again you're bruising the leaves, not too much, and let it sit for a few minutes. Start making the filling for your dumplings. We fried the meatball before, lightly, like so that it browned. Wash your hands really well because I crumbled this by hand. So just roughly using your hands, just crumble it. See the inside, even though it's a little hard on the outside, the inside is quite moist and not dry. And this can break up, but if you brown it too much, you're going to be left with really hard bits that don't work. When you mix it, it'll begin to take on like a sticky sort of consistency where it sort of sticks together like a pulp, like say you'd make a filling for a patty with like fish or mackerel, and it kind of becomes sticky that you can maybe roll it like this and it'll have form. So bring it to that consistency, keep mixing it. Okay, so if you can see, this is what it looks like. Make the dumplings, you can buy these dumpling wrappers. So what I do is I use a bit of flour on my hands and just on the wrappers so I can kind of get them to easily peel off and not stick to each other. So just what you can do is apply just a very little flour to it so that it won't stick. Now when you do that, they are like really light and doesn't stick, so it's easy to use. Add some flour to the water and mix it in so that it helps stick the dumpling wrappers when we're folding them. I use about roughly a tablespoon or so of the chili flakes, maybe a little less if you're not into spice, and a pinch of salt because I said like before it's seasoned. Now you have flour on your hands, so it's gonna help with the moisture and kind of bring it together more. So mix it in. If you know what I mean, like I told you before, I can almost create like a form with it. So you take one wrapper. I'm gonna do maybe two or three folds with you, so you can go with whatever you like. Add the filling. So one of the most popular ones, or the easy ones, is the simpler dumpling, like where you fold it like a patty. So you take a bit of the water and then you fold it like you would like a normal patty. So it's just really simple. So I've completed wrapping the dumplings. So these are the three folds that I did. And now we need to boil it. What you have to do is bring a big pot of water, not something shallow where it can sort of stick. Bring it to a boil, add the dumplings. Usually what happens is if the dumplings are heavy enough, it'll go down to the bottom, and once they're done, they'll float up to the top. So this has just begun to boil. Add your dumplings and place them in. See, they are at the top because they are quite light, but I know when they're cooked, when they become transparent. I'm gonna put all the dumplings in one go because there's quite a bit of space, but don't overcrowd it. You can gently place them in. Now we have to wait until it boils and sort of bubbles through. So you'd know when the dumplings are done, like I said, it'll become transparent, or like it'll float to the top. I'm going to serve the dipping sauce with it. They're quite sticky once they're done. This is some shallots and again sesame seeds for some crunch, because it's the texture, otherwise it's quite mellow and sort of glutinous. We're gonna taste one now. So it's quite tasty. The filling is salty and the spice really helps with the chili flakes. And the sauce really works best because there's a hint of sweetness to it. And like I said before, if you're not very much into like spicy, strong flavors, you can reduce the amount of chili flakes. I like spice. And I really like that the wrapper is glutinous and kind of chewy. And it's a texture that I really love playing with. So I really like it. So it's a really simple recipe to make. I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I'll see you next time on Homeworld.